How do you do, I?
Yeah,
well, so you've met my faithful demon slayer.
Welcome back, everyone.
Welcome.
More Blideo bams.
Demonic threat reduced by 25%.
Oh, thank God.
I know. I killed one more quarter of the demons.
I was really worried about all those, that quarter of demons. The other ones I'm...
But is it a quarter of the already reduced by a quarter demons, or is it a quarter of the original value?
Like,
it just occurred to me.
And every time she says reduced by 25%, and that's like your basis, then you're never going to run out of demons.
Yeah, that's a terrifying thought.
But how would that
work? I like to stop being demons.
At some point, you should reduce it to like one demon. So do you just you reduce it to one invincible demon?
And then they just kill that one demon and you're done.
So, or does it keep coming back? Or do you start having like half demons?
You have four demons left and you kill one of them and that's like demon invasion reduced by 25%. It's like, yeah, thanks computer, I know.
And then
you count.
Kill that last one.
It's like, yeah, I can count to four. Thanks.
And then like 3/4 of a demon comes back.
God,
and then you
die.
Kill that 3/4 of a demon, and there's and a 3/4 of that comes back.
That was
back.
The last one out of that gore nest too. That makes it even better. All right.
Well, there's a person.
Blue
he's
freaking...
definitely not gonna.
He's not.
How can you tell?
Because the ones that get up and start chasing you look like the regular demons, and this guy does not. This guy just
touché.
Looks like this guy just looks like he's been torn up a bit.
Touche.
Touchy.
Yeah, touchy.
Yeah.
Touchy feely.
That looks like another Japanese character.
Yeah, that's...
Looks like a Mo with a tail, actually.
Yeah, that's an actual kanji, I believe.
I think it is.
Yeah. Or at least a radical. I would be surprised if they were actually trying to make actual kanji and...
Yeah.
Kana here. I'm pretty sure it's just the aesthetic.
It's probably just for the aesthetic.
Like there's a lot of made up kana in like the Matrix programming thing.
Well, a lot of the Matrix is actually just backwards katakana.
Oh, that's
it's falling right. Backwards katakana.
You're probably right about that.
Yeah.
When I think about it, I just thought it was just wrong. Made up katakana.
Yeah.
You're probably right.
Yeah, it's just falling backwards katakana. And it looks really cool, I gotta hand it to him.
It does.
It's a really, really cool effect. That whole movie is just cool.
You know what my favorite thing about the Matrix movies is?
What?
A bunch of neckbeard meninists, incels love it.
Yeah.
And like, oh, red pilled, question society, jokes on them. It was made by two trans women.
Yeah.
And it's literally a metaphor for transitioning.
Uh-huh.
The red pill is literally estrogen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, welcome to hell, incels.
Oh my goodness, I just love that.
Jesus wow. Christ, I was down to one health point.
One health?
Yeah. I looked down after I killed that last one. I'm like, Jesus Christ, I was at one.
Well, I'm glad you did not die.
I ran entirely out of. Well, I have 4 shotgun ammo now. I had run entirely out of shotgun ammo.
We would have had. To refund everybody's money.
Yeah, everyone's
again.
Zero freaking dollars, man. I know.
Yeah.
Would have broken the bank.
There's Jessica again. What if it turned out that Jessica's the one making the announcements?
Yeah, hi, I'm Jessica. I've been making all these announcements.
Yeah, she's like programming the machine.
Yeah.
In real time.
Jessica. The power. The Chikara.
A new paradigm. And move humanity into the future. Yeah, and that future is demons.
What were we just talking about? Oh, the Matrix.
Yeah, we were talking about Matrix.
They're cool.
Yeah. I've never seen the sequels, but...
People hate them.
Just because the fact that nerds hate them makes me want to like them.
Yeah, I want to try watching them, actually, at some point. Because everyone freaking hates them. It's like, they can't be that bad.
Yeah, no.
Then again, that's also famous last words.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, maybe it could be that bad.
Because, like, I got most of my...
So where it came from, there it is. Where am I supposed to go? Well, maybe if I actually follow my little indicator there.
Because, like, most of my opinions, quote-unquote, about the Matrix movies, and a lot of movies, came from Nostalgia Critic, who I don't think is a good critic anymore.
Nah, he's a little...
took me long enough to realize.
A little weird. A little weird.
So I pretty much decided that any movie that I probably like.
Yeah.
Because I realized that I don't care about his idea of movies, because it's usually boring, stupid stuff.
Oh, there's a gore nest down here.
Oh, lovely. Jump down there. Oh, I thought you died for a second.
No. No, you can't. You don't take fall damage, which is real good.
Why don't you tear it?
I gotta kill the guys around it first. So I
have
to fight.
Oh, you have to kill things first?
No, you don't have to, but it makes it easier for me. Okay. I don't have to fight these guys and whatever comes when the gore nest gets blown up.
Oh, so stuff comes out?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Some more stuff gets summoned when you destroy the gore nest.
I thought stuff came out until you destroyed it.
No.
Oh.
When you destroy it, it summons a bunch of demons in.
You got a little hot right there.
Yeah, I got lit on fire a little bit.
You couldn't take the heat!
But yeah. Wachowski's makes some solid films.
Yeah, like I want to see more of theirs.
Yeah, ever seen Speed Racer?
I have not seen Speed Racer. I've heard some people say that they really love it.
A lot of people say they love it. A lot of people, the plot's really dumb. Of course, I mean it's about as dumb as the original show. It's about freaking racing and cars, racing and cars. But the way that it's filmed and like the way the color design is really cool. It's a really really cool movie.
Yeah,
like super,
also,
it's just absurdly colorful.
I'm interested
filmed
in seeing
very interesting
Cloud art. Atlas.
Yeah, I heard that one's pretty alright.
I'd even consider watching Jupiter Rising or whatever.
Jupiter Ascending.
Even though everyone
it sucks.
Hates on that. I don't care. I'm just going to say everyone hates it because it's about a girl. I just want to watch it for myself before I believe what anybody says about
my
it.
My sister watched it and she said it sucks.
Aww. That's unfortunate.
It's just ungood. Get those health pickups so I don't die.
Don't die.
I don't want to.
What other move? Weren't they involved with Sense 8?
Yeah, I think they directed it or whatever.
Yeah, they did something with it.
I think they directed it. I need to watch that damn show. People loved it.
Yeah, I'd be interested in watching it too. I have a lot of shows to catch up on.
Yeah.
Like even outside of anime, like I never watched She-Ra.
Yeah, She-Ra was.
I need to watch She-Ra.
She-Ra was really good so far.
It's
third
gay.
Season's coming out, I think the end of next week. Actually, it just got announced and they're like, hey, it's coming out in a week. And you're like, are you kidding me? Gotta give you a warm up.
I also just learned that
man.
Supergirl.
Yeah.
That's when that Supergirl's on Netflix.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah,
I need to watch
it.
I need to
watch
it.
That's where Joy's been watching it, apparently.
Oh, yeah. I need to freaking watch it. Apparently it's really good. Or at least some of it's good. Some of it's, like, very questionable.
It's part of where I got my name.
Yeah.
Like, when I was considering my name, I was looking at different media representations of, Kara's pronunciation to decide on the pronunciation, and Supergirl just happened to be the one that I watched the clip on, heard Kara, and decided, yeah, I'm gonna go with that pronunciation.
Kara
Only
Danvers.
To find out that it was actually just inconsistent in the first season, and then after set the first season, they just stuck to Kara.
Yeah, I mean, make it,
which is irritating.
In the DC continuity, it makes sense for it to be Kara because it's related to like. Other Kryptonian names, I guess.
Yeah, but
like Kal-El.
Yeah,
Superman's
actual
name.
I wanted it to sound like my name because I like Kara better.
Yeah.
So that made me sad.
I love when there's voice actors on like an animated show and they pronounce everything differently.
I think you cut out.
When
they pronounce everything.
When they pronounce stuff differently from each other.
That's what I figured you said, but I clarify.
Oh boy.
Ooh.
I just kicked his head in real good.
Ooh. Brutal. Legend.
Brutal legend. That's a
Weren't you playing that recently? Who was I talking
to
recently?
I've been playing a little bit. It's been a little while since I played it, but I got partway through it. It's pretty doggone amusing.
Yeah. It's got an awesome intro.
It's got a legendary intro.
Girlfriend.
Yeah, the freaking pop metal song.
I love it.
It's so freaking funny. It's like, Will, and the one janitor guy's just like, Will, metal's dead.
You ready for some heavy metal? Girlfriend.
Yeah, like for real. Yeah, okay, no. But I got a message on my phone, but it's just baseball updates.
Ugh, baseball.
Mariners doing badly. That's all that happens that I care about.
See, I was so excited when I learned about baseball, but then I learned it was like about, you know, like bases on the ground, like a home base type thing. I just thought people were throwing around giant violins and cellos, which I liked a lot more.
That would be pretty freaking hilarious.
I've been working on that bit all week. I'm pretty proud of it.
All right.
I'm actually testing out my new stand-up set. That's the opening joke.
Oh yeah.
I make people think that I only just recently learned what baseball is.
Yeah, and then you're just like, here's a funny, haha.
Yeah,
I'm funny.
That's what I think.
I'm a funny person. I'm a funny funster.
How funny I am.
I'm a funny funster person. Hey, could stuff stop exploding? That'd be cool.
For real though, I've been watching a lot of stand-up specials.
Yeah.
I need to watch
more of those off of like Netflix.
Yeah. Because I started with Hasan Minhaj's Homecoming King, which was really fun.
God, who's that one British? Who's that one British guy? Spends like
Daniel Sloss.
No, the one who spends
he's Scottish.
The one who spends like the entire first episode of his thing kneeling.
I don't know.
Because it doesn't start until you get on your feet or whatever.
He stands up
and turns on like a freaking stopwatch. Can't remember what his name is.
I saw.
But he's funny.
I watched Bo Burnham's Make Happy with
Jordan. Yeah, I need to watch some Bo Burnham.
Have you ever seen that?
No, I haven't seen like any
Bo
Burnham.
It is so good. Like, I'd say that it's one of like the best like pieces of, like performances ever.
You watched all of John Mulaney's stuff yet?
I watched one. I watched New Kid in Town.
I love New in Town. I love New in Town. That's a good one. I watched all three of them one day.
I'm sorry. Yeah, that's what we watched most recently. But we also watched both episodes of Daniel Sloss's Netflix special. And he's like Scottish. And that one was, those ones were also really touching in surprising ways. Really provocative, but still funny. It's just seeing like, especially Bo Burnham and him.
Yeah.
Appreciate the idea of stand-up as an art form more. So like, even not even as a joke, I do wish that I was capable, but I want to be good at stand-up. I don't know how, if I can ever be that great at it, because, you know, listen to me, I'm not that charismatic, no. Yeah. But it's a fun fantasy
to have.
You gotta
have a certain presence to do stand-up.
And, you know, I think...
You gotta, like, it works with charismatic people, it works with like really awkward people. You just gotta figure out what you're doing with it.
Yeah, I think even if you're not an actually charismatic person,
you just gotta learn to roll off of whatever your personality is.
Learn sort of to do it.
Yeah.
So I definitely think it's possible for anybody.
Yeah, you just gotta figure out your bits.
Whether good or not.
Like anything. You just gotta figure out what you're doing.
Yeah. And so I'm actually this coming quarter at school, this fall, I'm looking to join the, or at least visit the improv club.
Yeah.
Because cool. I really do want to work on my funny stuffs more. I think I can be pretty funny. It just doesn't always come out in Blideo Beams because I'm still trying to figure out my own voice and stuff.
Yeah.
I hope I'm at least entertaining here. Like, I think I am most of the time.
Yeah.
But I know I still have a lot to learn and a lot to experience.
Jesus.
So I think that'll just make me better as an overall performer as well.
Yeah.
Because that's the most important thing for video games for me. Like, yeah, I want to have fun making games, maybe get famous.
Internet famous.
I just think it's something that'll actually help me grow in multiple areas of performance, editing. So it's more than just a business venture. It's not even that.
Yeah.
It's just me trying to create something, because the sooner you start creating, the more you create, the quicker you'll get better.
There she is.
Oh, that's the lady.
Alpha 4. 0, 2.
I thought she was like dead.
No, she's still alive.
Why aren't we doing anything to stop her?
Because we can't. She's locked herself in that box.
Let's break into it. Doesn't that look kind of like a plug suit?
Yeah, what she's got on kind of looks like a plug suit. I think it's supposed to like a liner spine or something.
It looks kind of like
a lot of back trouble or something in the lore.
The plug suit things from Franks.
It does, yeah. That was a show that exists.
Yeah, I never finished it.
The ending wasn't great. I don't plan on it. The ending wasn't great.
Oh, did people die?
Stuff happens. It's really confusing.
did people just die? She was like, you cannot save them anyway.
Grid. To talk about the people who are gonna die when she opens the portal again. I think.
Oh, well, you're gonna stop it, right?
Do something about it, at least.
Are we still in, like, early game, or is this starting to get, like,
this
middle?
Is getting close to, like, the maybe beginning of the middle, maybe. It's still pretty early on.
Dang. I guess if you think about it, we haven't been playing that long.
No.
It just feels like it because the last time we played was a while ago.
Yeah. And this is the end of the stage here, so. I almost got all of it.
How long have we been going?
Uh, 17 minutes.
I think it's time we do next time on Blideo Beams.
Yeah, next time.
Next time on Blideo Beams, maybe we get deep again. Talk about stand-up comedy and growing as people.
Yeah.
Look forward to it. See ya.
Yeah, see ya.